Hey everyone, it's Sammy from Push Square, and I was going to do a more structured review for Sniper Elite 4, but if you've been following the channel, then you'll know technical issues have thrown me off the pace a little bit of late. So I'm just going to talk about my experience with the game so far. I have played through the entire campaign. I've spent a little bit of time with multiplayer and co-op, but I probably do a separate video on multiplayer and co-op because I haven't played anywhere near enough to really critically analyze those components of the game. But I have played through the campaign. I finished it last night, and I really enjoyed it. I like these Sniper Elite games. I think they're really fun. I think Rebellion has happened upon a really satisfying and enjoyable formula. And Sniper Elite 4, while it doesn't reinvent the wheel in any way, shape, or form, really, it's definitely a case of evolution rather than revolution, to coin an old phrase. But yeah, this is more of the same in many ways, but there are subtle little improvements under the hood that elevate it above the previous games in the series. And I think the main thing that makes this game stand out from sort of Sniper Elite 3 and certainly the ones on the PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 2 is that the levels are actually really big this time around. So you've got some ginormous stages, almost sandbox-sized stages, which are packed with optional objectives and all sorts of stuff. But the really entertaining thing is that all of the enemies live in that environment, and this opens up some massive sniping opportunities. Like, you can shoot people 600 and more meters off into the distance, which for a sniping game is, you know, part of the whole appeal, really. You want to get those really long range kills, and the massive levels really enable that. This game is set in Italy. Obviously the last game was set in Africa, now we're in Italy. The story isn't much to write home about, so I'm not even going to go into detail about that. There's some average to awful voice acting. One of the new things they do is there are like these little hub areas before you start a mission, where you can talk to different NPCs, and they give some context to the optional objectives and the kind of tasks that you're going to complete in the stage. And that's quite cool. You know, I like having all these optional objectives, because in each level, you kind of start the level, you kind of scout out where enemies are and stuff, and then you're sort of free to decide which tasks you're going to take on and how you're going to approach them. And that's really entertaining. It gives you a freedom to sort of go about your business in any way you like. And it forces you to, or it encourages you at least, to think on your feet. So one of the things that's changed as well is kind of the artificial intelligence. In the previous game, I believe, there was this relocation mechanic, which I personally never really got a grapple on it. In this game, there's more of a triangulation method. So if you're in a kind of sniping nest or whatever, and you shoot someone, the guards will start searching, trying to find where that shot came from. And the more you shoot, the more noise you make, they'll sort of triangulate your position, and then they'll come and try and flush you out from it. And this is cool because I think it's designed to be exploited. Certainly that's the way I played the game. You know, you'd draw the Nazis onto your position, and then you've got kind of these new traversal methods. There are lots of traps like tripwires and stuff, and you can kind of pull them into your position and either flank them, or you can sort of direct them towards all of your traps, and that's really entertaining and really fun. And I enjoyed that aspect of the game quite a lot. It looks good though. There's a lot of kind of copy and paste assets. You'll see similar sort of computer terminals, similar desks and all that kind of stuff. So some of the levels feel quite familiar, despite there being a lot of environmental variety. Like, you go from one, there's a viaduct in a kind of forest type area, and then on another level there's you're like in a kind of coastal fishing town. So at the top level, there's some variety between kind of the settings and the stages. But what you'll notice when you sort of go inside buildings and stuff is there's a lot of samey interior design and stuff like that, which I think is just a consequence of the budget. You know, these big games for PS4 now are expensive and hard to make. And I'm not going to knock Rebellion for not outsourcing tons of different assets out to China in order to give the game that real variety in terms of the locales and stuff. But it does look good. I played on the PS4 Pro. It runs at more or less 60 frames per second. There are a few drops, but nothing that's going to really influence or hinder gameplay too much. And what I like about the game as well is that you've got options, like in terms of you start out sniping, right? Every level I kind of took the same approach in that I would try to go undetected. I would kind of tag all my enemies. You can use environmental sounds to kind of mask your shots and stuff like that, which has been in previous games and is really fun as usual again here. But I would inevitably get spotted eventually, and then I would kind of change my tactic. I would try to set up traps. I would sometimes just go into straight up third person gunfights. And I think what the game's good at is letting the kind of missions play out quite organically. Like you can go from sniping in stealth to going into a full out gun battle with assault rifles and stuff, to going back to stealth, to going undercover and just using melee attacks to take people out. There are lots of different ways that you can tackle all the missions, and like I say, with all of these optional objectives in the map, you can kind of play the way that you want to play, which is really fun, I think. And while the game is an open world, the levels are, like I mentioned earlier, very big. And there's quite a bit of verticality to them. Sometimes you go into underground basements. Sometimes you're climbing to the top of a tower to get a good vantage point. There's lots of things to see and do. There is an abundance of collectibles, and I think they've gone a bit crazy here. It's all optional, of course, but I think there are probably way too many collectibles. There's everything from sort of stone towers to a pop-up just appeared on my computer. God, you can tell how rustic this review is, can't you, that I'm having to close pop-ups from my computer. Sorry about that. No, what I was saying is there are lots of collectibles. There's stuff like stone eagles that you can snipe. Most guards have like letters on their body, so if you're searching guards, which you need to get lots of ammunition back, you'll find letters and stuff like that. But it's a bit OTT for me. The game does feel quite gamey, which I don't mean as in a negative way, but there's tons of like XP gauges and kind of weapon mastery statistics and all these kind of sub challenges and stuff, and it does feel like a little bit overwhelming at times, but it's all easily ignorable. Like, you don't have to partake in any of that. You can just go and complete the missions if you want to. And I quite like the way that the XP meter is sort of linked for, and this was the same in Sniper Elite 3, but you use the same XP meter for co-op, for multiplayer, for single player, for whatever you want to do in the game. So it always feels like you're progressing, and it always feels like you're unlocking stuff whichever mode you play. And I think that all filters into the fact that this is a game designed to be played how you want to play it. You can play stealth, you can play co-op and go guns blazing, you can play multiplayer and master your weapons that way. You can do kind of whatever you want to do, how you want to do it, and the game gives you just the tools to have fun. And I really appreciate that. I think Rebellion have got really good at doing this, and I enjoy the game a lot. Yeah, I mean, it's a good game. There's really not much else to add about it. Like I say, I haven't massively gone into the multiplayer and co-op yet, but I enjoyed playing through the campaign. The latter levels, I think Rebellion has this tendency to just throw an abundance of enemies at you, and the latter levels in Sniper Elite 4 do fall into that trap. I think I killed in the last level, I got discovered and I had to, I couldn't stealth it. I'm not good enough at stealth. And in the last level, I ended up killing like 150 people, which must have been like the entirety of the map. So that was a bit over the top for me. And Rebellion does like to flood the map with lots of enemies. I remember the last level of Battle Zone is insane for a similar reason. But other than that, it's a really fun game. It's not massively different to the previous entries. If you've played Sniper Elite before, then you kind of should have an idea of what you're going to get out of Sniper Elite 4. It is the best version, I think. I think the bigger maps sort of lead to much better sniping opportunities, and they play into that kind of freedom that I was talking about earlier, where you can approach the missions exactly how you want to, and the game doesn't kind of force you down any particular paths. It just lets you experiment, and for that reason there's lots of replayability as well, especially when you factor in the co-op, and the entire campaign can be played co-op, which is really nice addition. So yeah, just a really nice, really rounded game. The production values, there's some dodgy animations in there, the voice acting can be a bit off, and like I say, it's a good looking game, but it's not the best looking game you're going to see on the PS4. And yeah, you know, it does have its moments. The fishing village level particularly looks incredible, and there are a couple of others where you've got this just really gorgeous vista. Obviously Italy is a beautiful country, so it makes for a great setting for a game. But yeah, Sniper Elite 4, let me know in the comments section below if you've got any questions about the game, or whether you're planning to pick this one up, whether you're a fan of the series or not. I'm sorry this review is a little not my usual standard, but like I say, I'm just trying to get back on my feet after all these technical issues I've had. I'm sorry to Rebellion that Sniper Elite is the game that I end up reviewing straight after all the technical issues, because I would have liked to have put in a bit more effort and really scripted this review. But hopefully this puts across my feelings on the game, and hopefully it helps you out in deciding whether you're going to pick it up. I do think it's a good game, and I'm glad they make these games, you know? It's nice to have, it's like comfort food, I find, Sniper Elite. It's just wholesome fun, and that kill cam mechanic that they've got going on is always exceptional. There are some just brilliant and brutal kills in this game, but it's kind of so brutal that it also it almost becomes comical, if you know what I mean. I think it's that kind of gore in this game, which I also appreciate and enjoy. And yeah, I enjoyed my time with Sniper Elite 4, and I'll come back to it so I can tell you a little bit more about the multiplayer, hopefully in a much better video than this one. But like I say, leave any comments below if you've got any questions or any thoughts about the game, and thank you so much for watching.